All right, here I'm starting out the project of building a fountain and the garden beds on either side. So the first thing I did was clear out the spot of dirt, kind of graded a little bit, and I'm setting 4x4 posts. Two right there for the back, and two right there for the side of the garden beds. And then I started laying out all my tools, some spare wood, and the OSB board and the Hardy Backer board that I'm going to be using. So first thing is to set those posts. I already dug the holes, and I'm going to set them with concrete. This is how far I got in the one day that I worked on it. So I have the basic outline of it and the Hardy Backer up. And on this side, I poured this and I kind of calculated out how much concrete I'll need for that. That's 5.5 bags. So I'm gonna need at least 10 bags to do this. So I'm gonna start again tomorrow and have the rest of the material ready and hopefully pour this tomorrow. All right, so we got the outline of how this mold is gonna be. I have just about everything ready, graded on the bottom, leveled on top. I got the concrete I need. I'm doing high strength on the very bottom layer with rebar, and then I'm going to start putting in this Portland cement. So this is the main ingredient for concrete, except it doesn't have all the rocks and pebbles and stuff in it and sand. So I'm going to start mixing this up and pouring it in slowly. I predicted it was going to be about 10 bags. And I have about 12 bags, so hopefully I don't run out or low. All right, here I go. So I poured the concrete last night. It took me a lot longer to mix the concrete in a 5-gallon bucket than I thought. I went through 8 bags of concrete for this, which is how much I thought I was gonna go through. So now I have 2 more bags that I'm gonna use on the bottom, but first I'm gonna start taking the mold plywood, the plywood that makes the mold, start taking that apart so that I can then pour the bottom of the fountain. And then I still need to add Hardy Backer to this 2x4 section, the front and the side and the top. All right, so this is what we got for the inside. And now I'm about to mix up the concrete for the bottom. All right, so there's the bottom. I mixed the high strength concrete with the plastic concrete to get that kind of smooth finish like the rest of it. Poured it in there. It's not smooth on the bottom yet. I'll smooth it out when it dries out a little bit more. But that's getting close to all the concrete being done. I'm excited about that. It's a backbreaking work to mix the concrete by hand in a 5 gallon bucket. For this much concrete, I almost would have done one of those tumblers. So we have the mold plywood off of all four sides, inside and outside. And then I went and put Hardy Backer on the 2x4s that are exposed. And then next up is mixing stucco and applying to the sides. I'm going to apply the sides and the 2x4 surrounding it, and then leave the flat area in the back for tile. And then I'm gonna stucco this entire thing. All right, here's the finished product. The fountain's running off of the solar panel. We have the light inside of it that's running off of the rest of the low voltage lighting, landscape lighting. I have the garden beds. I filled them up with raised bed soil, mixed it with the native soil, and planted some starter plants. So, one thing I would do differently is make sure the mold that you're building, the sides and filling with concrete, are straight. And maybe not use OSB board, use a flat board so you don't have a lot of rough texture. And probably, I mean, I might do this in the future, but I might try to tile the front. But yeah, that's the finished product. So next, besides fixing up the fountain a little bit more, putting more tile on it, I'm gonna do beds on the fence, probably about 2 feet out, and do about 2 layers of it, and on both sides. And I'm gonna do like lettuce and herbs up there. So just more garden growing space. But yeah, so far so good. I mean, the fountain itself is a good sound. It's a little bit echoey when you're up close to it because it's such a big basin, but it sounds pretty nice if you're further away. Well, on to the next project.